down with the divine Julia Hunter. Now we're on to detailed, superficial, yet pertinent, ripply, crepey skin. So I'm 55. I've been very fit all my life. My arms have always been great, Julia. So to me, my arms are fine.
Your arms are fine.
You know, my arms are fine. And yeah. I do also, every morning, I do this. I pinch my slack.
Which is great for lymphatic. Exactly.
So I do that and pinch.
Yeah.
I do do your whole body pads.
Yeah.
Everywhere.
Fabulous.
Okay.
Yeah.
This, where my knees, for many years, I've done this, not even on one. They talk to one another. Hello, good morning. How are you? I'm fine. It's like Sesame Street. It's gone wrong. But there's that excess skin. And then here, there's that kind of ripple. And many of us will have this. Go right in. I don't mind, darling. It's that internal ripple where you see that rippling on the side.
So number one is lymphatically, okay? Yeah. So you were talking about how you slap and whatever,
Yes.
That helps the lymphatics because part of cellulite is lymphatics, mm-hmm. okay? Mm-hmm. The more you exercise, the more lymphatically you drain and it helps this. The other thing is when you exercise, okay, you should make sure you're doing the things that are exercising, particularly these muscles, your butt, okay, the back of your thighs, because you've got great muscles. It's just genetically you lay down this fat.
Yeah.
And lymphatically, when you see cellulite, lymphatically people poorly drain. So again, exercise, walking, walking up the stairs, carrying your own groceries, all that stuff qualifies as exercise.
Yeah.
Okay, then the other thing you look at, your estrogen is probably higher, probably was higher.
I had zero estrogen when I got myself diagnosed.
Because...
you mean when I still was getting my periods?
When you were still getting your periods, okay. But the other thing is when you see fat right here and right here, and one of the hormones that people forget to look at is growth hormone, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So growth hormone, when you see this, I always do people's growth hormone blood levels because it generally means your growth hormone is low. Okay, so fine and dandy, that's all part and parcel of it.
So would you then take growth hormones?
Well, nowadays you don't give growth hormone, you do growth hormone releasing hormone because your body can make growth hormone until you die. It just loses the
momentum,
the chemical messenger. And so now you can give the chemical messenger and it helps burn this sort of stuff, okay? So why do people have cellulite, okay? Because the collagen fibrils, which are like chicken wire, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And the fat sort of pokes through because the chicken wire gets weak, okay? And so people get a little bit of cellulite.
Now, in the big picture, you don't have much cellulite,
but you have some veins, and part of that is because in fat, where people genetically lay it down, is you'd have poor blood supply in fat.
Yeah,
okay?
Yeah.
So that's why slapping it, exfoliating it and exercising these particular areas really help. So then what else do you do, okay?
Mm-hmm.
In the big picture, you really don't have crepey skin. I mean, I'm looking at your skin. Look, the farther you get away from your heart, the drier your skin gets because your thyroid's low, okay? It's easy to get blood down here, hard to get it back up. And so the more you moisturize, the more you drink water, the more you eat olive oil, the more you eat whole ground flax or linseed meal, M-E-A-L, okay?
Yes.
That was my accent.
Yes.
The better it is for hydrating your skin. And so the only other thing you can do after that, there's only two things.
Yeah.
Number one is you can do a high dose retinoic tretinoin peel, okay, which basically forces new collagen production. So it takes the chicken wire and tightens it up.
Are we going to do that today?
Okay, which is what we're going to do.
Yeah.
I'm going to roll it with the roller first, little needles, because it makes it...
I always encourage them to do body microneedling, so this
is
brilliant.
Body microneedling, which is excellent, okay, because what does it do? It forces new collagen production, brings in a new blood supply, so it helps all these veins, helps everything. So we're going to do that, and the only other thing you can do after that is laser it.
I'm very aware of how many chemicals I'm putting on my face. So I use your Night Regeneration Vitamin A, but I think to myself, if I do a lot of my body in a strong chemical, that's all going ultimately into my bloodstream. So,
liver, yeah.
Into my liver, yeah. Exactly. Because vitamin A, liver, it's like when I took
Roaccutane. It's a fat-soluble vitamin.
It goes straight there. Yeah. So your liver can get weaker. So how do you then say to yourself, I'm going to do something like, I mean, if it's obviously like your peel pads, that's just a lactic peel.
Yeah,
so
that's just fine. The surface.
It's fine. The retinol's going deep, so... Like, if you're going to do retinol with me now, how do you decide?
There's only so much you can put on at one time.
Ah, okay, fine.
When we do a high-dose retinol peel, okay, I just said to Trinny, look, I can do the front of your thighs, but I can't do the whole leg, okay, because it's too much.
Yeah.
Okay, or you can just do the arms at one time.
Okay.
So with a lot of people, what we'll do is they're always on a schedule for doing their body, okay? A lot of
times they come to you in a year and they'll do,
yeah.
This week it's a thigh, then it's the arm.
Well, and you
give
it a month or 6 weeks between. And like a lot of times we'll do these peels for people who had back acne or have back acne, okay? Because it clears it up.
Yeah.
Okay, or scarring.
Fantastic.
Okay, clears it up.
So they're quite deep peels, these peels we're going to do.
Yeah.
Great, let's get started.
How high a dose of retinol should you use?
Okay, so the strongest Retin A, which is tretinoin, which is prescription, is 1%.
First of all, just going back a second, microneedle, so this is this two?
That's a two.
That's a two. Now, a two, never, ever use at home, ladies. I, on my face, do 0.5, maybe a one. Very light feathering. So I just want to really, because a lot of women get very encouraged when they watch things and they go out and they order from Amazon.
Oh, yeah,
two needle.
No.
Like, I do a one on my body. I would never put myself in hands of a two unless it was a professional holding it. Just to say.
And also, the other thing is, look, I'm not going to try to kill you here, okay? I mean, basically, I'm not going to try to kill you. Okay? The thing is, I'm just lightly rolling it because what I'm doing is making little channels because the retinoic is gonna suck in, wick in like a candle.
Yeah.
Okay, so all I'm doing is just opening up the skin a little
bit. To make
it
easier.
So it wicks in faster.
Yeah.
I'm a huge fan of these just like you are, okay?
Yeah.
Because look, just this, if you just use this, it's gonna force new collagen production in the epidermis and at the dermal epidermal junction, okay? So all of that is going to help veins, it's going to help the skin.
Yeah.
So I've got people who, look, they, you know, as much as they have time to do it, they're just rolling everything on rotation, basically.
And I mean, what I find when I roll at home, Julia, is I feel a thickening of my skin because I feel the texture change. So
that's
I have actually rolled here on and off for 2 years.
Yeah.
And if I feel the structure here, as you said, my skin could be a lot
more
crepey.
Collagen.
And it's because I do rolling there. I'm not good at remembering to roll there.
Yeah.
That's probably why it's weaker. But I do feel that underlying strength. These bits.
Roll the saddlebags. Because what they do is it thickens them up, and that helps so you don't have cellulite there.
Okay.
What we're going to do is the middle part, okay?
The bit
that's
saggy.
So here's the weak vector right here.
Mm-hmm.
It basically goes from the middle of your leg here to the middle of the back there,
mm-hmm.
okay? So basically, I'm not trying to kill Trinny. I'm not trying
it's
to
like
draw blood.
It's like some uncomfortable tickling.
If it doesn't hurt, it doesn't work. And so there it is. So the bottom line is, I was turning on your stem cells.
Yes, you were. You so were. Stimulation stem cells.
Absolutely, turning on your stem cells.
So you're not out to draw blood here or create a little
blood
thing.
I'm lightly
you're feathering.
Going over
yeah.
this,
yeah.
okay? Because at the end of the day, it just gives you a better result.
And then she's created some channels now, and she's going to put quite a strong retinol. What do you call it, Julia? Retinol?
This one's called Total Body Peel, which is tretinoin. Okay.
What percentage are you putting on?
Look, if there's such a thing as 100%, this is 100%.
That's 100%.
Okay. Wow. Here's what it looks like. Because tretinoin, any sort of Retin A or really good
so
retinol,
really yellow.
Is this color.
Yeah, and then it's diluted and diluted according to what percentage they're selling you.
Percentage you want, and you can always smell. The stronger it is,
you can smell it. Okay,
you can smell it. Okay, And so
this will cause me to... So you're going to do this first and then do a peel.
Well, so this is basically considered a peel.
Okay.
Okay.
But you talked about we might do a peel. Is this what you mean?
So
this is going to make my whole body peel.
This is this retinol, okay? Retinoic more makes it flake than actually peel.
You said I'm going to peel like a lizard.
Yeah, okay. What I'm going to put on top of this is a healthy acid peel. Yeah. What this is doing is penetrating down into the dermis, and then it's pushing the skin off by making new skin. So it's by making new skin, it's then pushing the dead skin, the old skin, the skin at the top off, because it's making new skin.
Yeah.
So it's replacing old, tired, and making new collagen, and new collagen is what lifts and tightens.
And because we're accelerating the process, because this happens to people normally, but I suppose it happens much slower when you're older, and if you do a normal retinol program on your skin,
and as your diary gets lower, as we go down the path of life, our cells are trying to retire. And so what are we doing by doing all of this is we're waking them up and making them come out of retirement.
Yeah.
Okay? We're basically forcing them. The goal is to make your body run the marathon, but you have to support that. You can't run the marathon and not support that with nutrition and whatever. But that's what I'm doing here. It's signaling to the body to force to make new collagen production. Yeah. Look, you eat healthily, you exercise, your hormones are good overall. So it's forcing new collagen production, okay?
Yeah.
So there's number one. Then I'm going to do the other side.
Okay.
And then I'll come back and put the acid on top of it.
Oh, it feels like nothing. It feels like Julius is rubbing some cream to my
head. Yeah, exactly.
That's what it feels like. And the needling was just like little pricks. But I have a very high pain threshold, but also it didn't really happen.
Okay, now, if you see, I'm not rubbing this in, it's just soaking it in, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And you watch it, it'll get less and less yellow.
Yeah.
That's because where I rolled it,
okay,
it just starts sucking it in.
Yeah.
Now.
Sucking it in,
that's right. It's all just soaked in.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, look at the difference.
Yeah.
Just soaked in.
It's loving it, Julia.
Loves
the retinol.
And also because I rolled it, it's why it just
soaked
in.
Yeah. Whereas otherwise
it's
on the top.
When it sucks in like this, what it means is your body is, it's like welcoming friends, okay? It is so happy to have.
Welcoming friends. I'm going to have a party for you.
There you go.
It's just all
it's singing the hallelujah chorus. I'm letting this, and then now I'm going to come and do the acid here. So acid is
really
gelatinous, okay?
I didn't know.
And the reason is because acid, the nature of the chemistry of it is it's always gelatinous, particularly a hypoglycemic.
Because when we see it in a shop, it's not like that size at all.
This is really high dose.
Okay, fine.
Okay? I mean, this is a really high dose. Okay. It's not going to kill you.
Okay.
It's just going to make, it's going to sting some because I've made the holes.
Okay.
And it usually takes it a minute or so before it starts to
sting.
Okay. But you see how it dissolves in.
Immediately.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now this is what's going to make you peel like a snake.
It's a bit stingy, but it's nothing. It's like...
it's
going to
sting
a
little
like
bit
a
more in a second.
Yeah, a little bit more in a second.
As it starts wiggling into the hole.
And how do you know when it's stinging too much or does it not? Is that just...
Oh, it doesn't sting too much. So it takes it about a week to start peeling.
Yeah.
And maybe 10 days, but up in your upper legs, it's usually about a week.
Okay.
And then it... peels for about 2 weeks because the farther you are away from the heart, the longer it takes for it to peel.
Okay.
But even if your people are putting on a lower dose, okay,
and they don't peel like a snake.
Yeah.
Anything that you put on there that peels it is better than not putting on something that peels if it's a healthy acid, okay?
And but this is not something you would do at home.
No.
You wouldn't do this kind of peel at home because it's way too strong and it's something that has to be done by a doctor.
Right. And also, look, whenever you put acid on, this acid does go into your lymphatics, etc., in the sense of, so what I say to people is, always drink, you know, the goal is to drink more water. You want to drink, ideally, at least, I mean,
two liters a day.
Most people, nobody needs really more than 2 liters a day unless you're running the marathon.
Yeah.
Okay? But, it's, and it you notice how it's turning red.
Yeah.
And that's where it's going into the, and now up here, definitely. But this will make it, Trinny will be very happy with this.
I'm so excited. I've never, ever had treatment like this in my life, apart from my little home, you know, my home things where I noticed a bit of difference. And I've always, before I even met you, Julia, there were women who came to see you had these whole body peels. And I always heard about them because they're quite famous.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm very excited to be lying here actually having it done for the first time.
These...
And to have it done in winter as well, not near summer.
Yeah, that's the
kind of thing as well. You can't really do these in the summer, can you?
And the other thing is, look, I do myself, when I can't stand myself, what do? I give myself a peel. Number one is,
when I can't stand myself, what do?
Yeah, I give myself a peel.
This is pigment blind. So you can use this on skin of any color.
Yeah.
It makes everybody's skin better, okay? Yeah. And it's because what it's going to do is the acid's going to peel off everything with your epidermis, okay? It's going to, as it peels it off, your epidermis and your dermis, at the dermal-epidermal junction, you have a barometric sensor. So as your epidermis thins, it turns on the stem cells in your dermal-epidermal junction, and it forces the stem cells to start making new skin cells, okay?
Okay.
So
that's exactly
then
what it's doing
that
inside.
Feeds back to the dermis,
yeah.
Okay? And the dermis then has to make new collagen, and that's part of what tightens.
And tell me, how long will it be getting those messages for before it relapses into its old life path?
Oh, it takes really 3 months to get the full effect.
And then after, will your skin then revert back?
Well, then your skin, look, again, as we go down the path of life, okay, our bodies are always trying to retire.
Yeah.
And so, look, I have people who do these maybe once a year, okay, maybe every year and a half.
Yeah.
I mean, whenever they get unhappy with themselves.
Okay.
But, again, the more internally you're keeping everything healthy, the better.
I think, Julia, I just want to thank you so much.
But it's important to look good on the outside and the inside.
Holy
so there you go.
I agree, honey.
There you go. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye.
Goodbye, ladies. Ladies, a little update. It's now been 5 days since I did the Julia Huntel peel. Where she put the retinol, you can see, wojo, I'm shredding. And in here, I was shredding quite a lot. But that is like baby skin, that skin. Lulu, if you feel that skin, like a piece of marble, just feel.
Oh, wow.
Like a piece of marble. I don't know about anything else, but it's really interesting. Where she's done the acid, it hasn't peeled so much, so I don't know if I'm going to shred in 10 days, but we'll keep you updated as it keeps going.